Now it is time for model class 3, the so-called why models. What do we want to explain? Well, just like before, we want to describe the empirically observed interspike interval distribution. But now we want to ask a different question. We don't want an equation that describes how the brain does it. We want an equation that describes why doing it like that would be a good idea. If you want, we want to ask the question that's behind the how. So let me wear my why hat. What will I argue if I'm a scientist following the why idea? Well, I will say that we know that the interspike interval histogram looks like an exponential. In fact, my how friends feel they understand how that comes about. But why is that good? Evolution could have come up with different distributions. For example, evolution could make excitation and inhibition not be balanced. So we want to ask the question that's behind it. Why is it the way it is? So we could view it as an optimization problem. The objective could be maximize the information transmitted by interspike intervals and ask which interspike interval distribution would transmit most information. So for that, we need a definition of information. And for that, we will use the entropy. The entropy here to the base B is the sum over all possible values, in this case, the sum over all possible interspike intervals, times the probability that this interspike interval will occur, times the log to the basis B of that probability. And there's two bases that are commonly used. There's E being used for nats, and 2 is being used for bits, which you most certainly know from interacting with your computers. So what would be the information in a unimodal distribution? Intuitively, there's no information. It's always the same interspike interval. So why would that be the case? Well, P of X is high. No, it will be 1 for that value. It will be 0 otherwise. But the log of 1, regardless of what the base is 0. Therefore, for a unimodal distribution, the contained information will be 0 bits. If we have a bimodal distribution, we expect that it tells us 1 bit per time bit per observation. Why was that going to be the case? The probability for each of the peaks will be 0.5. The log to base 2 will be minus 1. We have a minus here. So each of them will add 1. So we have 1 plus 1. Each of them are weighted with 0.5. Therefore, what we have here is 1 bit of information per interspike interval. And of course, if we have a uniform distribution, we will get more bits. In fact, we will get most bits. So it's time for you to implement the entropy function.